This is going to be a tough one to talk about, everybody. First up, I'm sorry. I really don't like putting out videos that talk about depressing subjects like this, because it's not what anybody really wants to hear. And on face value, it may not seem to matter over things like the end of Kerr's miniature railway, or do vintage coaches deserve more attention, or which standard gauge UK heritage railway was first, the Bluebell or the Middleton? That's an easy one, by the way. It was the Middleton, albeit by a couple of weeks. But when it's all said and done, there's a few things which have been on my mind during the last quarter or so of 2020, so I hope you'll allow me to release a bit of stress on behalf of railway-related YouTubers and welfare officers in the rail industry, as well as just people in the rail industry in general. As you probably remember, I didn't exactly have the best beginning to the year anyway, off the back of someone pirating two of my videos via a fake railway page on Facebook, who then decided that my videos belonged to him and leaving me powerless despite me showing the evidence to suggest otherwise. By the middle of March, that battle was over and the coronavirus was still not being taken too seriously, but just as my plans were about to be put into action for the coming year, everything shut down and I suddenly had to postpone everything I planned until 2021, at least. I admit, after the COVID editorial I did in the middle of the year, I hesitated doing a follow-up as things progressed, seeing as the situation has been changing from day to day and there's generally nothing else to say other than, yeah, that railway's had to lay some staff off and yeah, social distancing remains in place, and yeah, pricing per compartment sucks if you're on your own, but railways need to cover their costs, and yes, these railways couldn't run during the Santa season, blah 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 blah. But the main reason I didn't talk about COVID at any great length was because I felt, as effectively what you could argue an entertainer, there was a responsibility for me to come up with topics that would help everyone take their mind off things and keep living in hope. Hence, I spent most of my time reviewing more railway-related films and TV shows for people to check out while they had nothing else to do. And I'm glad that it seemed to have helped in some small way. I'm glad that everybody seemed to enjoy the review of God's Wonderful Railway, although credit really should go to Avril Rowlands for being my guest. That was really nice of her. I'm thrilled that the time-hopping editorial proved to be such a hit, because it seemed to be just a throwaway idea that I flung together while I was trying to catch up with other things for me to review. Though it can't really overlook the fact that putting off talking about negatives can have an effect on one's mental health. And this really is the crux of the issue. Me personally, I've had my strains in 2020 as much as anybody has, and I've come out the other end with few long-term scars. But the fact that so many people struggled in 2020 has weighed on my mind, and no doubt it's weighed on the minds of other people who are in my shoes. People like Jeff Marshall, Laurie Rose, Jago Hazard, Anthony Leslie Dawson, Sam's Trains, Jay Foreman, Victor Tanzig, etc. They've all had a hard time of things in their own way in 2020. Okay, Sam kind of brought a hard time on himself for the whole El Cheapo thing, which really wasn't that funny or that good a send-up of himself. But even so, the subsequent backlash, subsequent reaction to said backlash, and subsequent backlash to said reaction of said backlash proves that negativity is so much more powerful than positive vibes. Now obviously, there are more critically necessary professions out there, and most of those who undertake those professions have been strained to the utmost in 2020. But even if something like the clap for the NHS was dreadful compensation for lack of appropriate wages for health workers, the public still took it as a thank you for their efforts, until they clocked that it was actually a cover-up for something more political. Whereas YouTubers, rail workers and mental health services don't seem to get that sort of equivalent. Jeff does a video promoting a mental health service from Network Rail, and there's still dickheads on Facebook who say that he and his wife don't have real jobs. A gateline assistant in the Southampton area works through the pandemic, gets the virus and recovers, only to have gangs of people not wearing masks strolling around like they're on an extended holiday. Cheers, lads. In terms of COVID, we're obviously not out of the woods just yet. As of recording this editorial, less than 1% of the UK's population had been vaccinated, and those in authority say we need about 30% of the population done before things can start returning to some form of normality. So at this present rate, we're realistically looking around the middle of March before most railways can think about running trains again. And even when we are, preservation societies face an uphill struggle to overcome. In June last year, Laurie Rose produced an appeal telling people that once lockdown is over, that's when heritage railways are really going to need volunteers. So if you haven't already, please do check it out. And if you haven't been sure about volunteering at your local heritage railway before, maybe this year would be a good time to change that. But having said that, the attitudes that some heritage railways may have held against faces that don't quite fit are still prominent and can also be a strain on mental health. You may remember the whole situation of Alistair Burgess and the Lenton & Barnstaple Railway back in May 2019, which I'm sorry to say eventually resulted in things working out against Alistair's favour. But he has been in touch since and reported that he's now happily working for Network Rail as a crossing keeper, so he's happily gone on to much better things. Great for him. Nevertheless, anybody being proverbially invalided out of any hobby on account of any learning inconvenience or gender or sexual orientation just isn't on. It's bad enough that women are still singled out, and films like TfL Media's The Railway Woman have to be made with a more serious message to them. You can support the making of that film via the GoFundMe link in the description, for the record. Please do support it. I don't know how every heritage railway is going to recover from this. We've already seen the South Tynedale Railway going into administration, but given things were already looking bleak going into 2020 with a coal crisis looming, and now confirmed with the last of Britain's deep coal mines due to stop in 2022, it's a miracle that we've come through it as well as we have. And that miracle kind of extends to all of us as individuals. Mentally, this has been one of the worst years of our lives, especially those of us who had just had to keep on working at the risk of catching the damn virus. Many of us have caught it and just had to keep on working right after recovery. I've made a point of giving a shout out to all the key workers watching this show, but I've neglected to give a shout out to the likes of Jeff, Laurie, Anthony, Jago, Victor, etc., because they've just kept plodding along despite issues of their own too. So, to all of you YouTubers, welfare officers, and indeed anybody in key sectors and industries who have just kept plodding through this whole sorry saga, worked things through, and reassured people in your own way that everything will be just fine one day, thank you for your staying power. If any of you are feeling the effects of bad mental health taking their toll on you, please don't hesitate to seek help. I've left a few helplines and support services in the description below, but if anybody here can also recommend who to seek help from, please do share it in the comments, as you'll also be helping in your own way. And whatever happens, I hope that my own attempts to keep people distracted, maybe even entertained, might have helped to maintain your own mental health in some way. I'm Chris, and mental health or otherwise, I'm here to gauge the issue.